Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. I hope you guys are enjoying the Navratri series. So in this video, I wanted to try something new. So very frequently, I'm asked about the foundations I use, foundations, shades I use, what do I think about a certain foundation, etc. So I just thought I'll review 10 of my most used foundations and I'll give you guys my shade reference, if it's darker to my skin or lighter to my skin, just so that, you know, whenever you have a doubt, I can reference you back to this video and you'll even have an idea of what I think about these videos. About this foundation and whether I like it or I don't like it, which skin is supposed to use it, what shade I am supposed to use, like, you know, all various different type of things. So yeah, if that's something you want to watch, then yeah, please continue watching. So we have a mixture of drugstore and luxury foundations, and so just so that, you know, we have balance and we cover all things. There are a lot of other foundations, but I just picked these 10 for today, and if you like it, then I can do a second version of with more 10 foundations I use and like compare and match. So the first foundation, we'll get this out of the way. I know you guys see me like use this constantly, but that is the Maybelline Fit Me, absolute favorite from drugstore. Such an affordable, you know, foundation. For every foundation, I'm going to talk about 4 points. So one is skin type, next is finish, then coverage, and the next is the shade I use. So first, let's start off with a Fit Me. Now in Maybelline Fit Me, I am in the shade 310. Now this is a tad bit lighter and it's a very, very neutral foundation shade, but it really does work with me. Like whenever I don't have any tan, then this works really beautiful for me. But if I tan a bit, then it kind of gets a little lighter. So I've tried 330 as well, but 330 is a little too dark. Then I tried 320, but 320 is a little too pink on my skin. So that's the reason I just use this, and I've kind of mix one drop of a foundation which is a little darker or a little yellow so that it gets balanced out usually. So this is a foundation really, really good for normal skin and oily skin, but I kind of think even dry skin can work with it if you hydrate your skin really well. It's a very like nice finish. It's not too matte, not too dewy. It's a very properly balanced formula. I've seen a lot of dry skin people also use it. Then next, finish is a demi matte finish. It doesn't dry down completely matte, which is really nice actually, according to me. So it gives a very nice finish. Then the coverage, it's a medium to full coverage foundation. I'm in the shade 310. And regarding the shade range, on Nykaa, we have 18 ranges, but I think in US, we have like 30 or 35 plus. So that's the first foundation and we're going to put this aside. So the next foundation we're going to talk about is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Matte Foundation. So this is the first foundation Fenty launched. So when I bought it initially, I really, really loved this foundation. Okay, this was like when I was in... I didn't know much about makeup. Actually, this expired. I don't use this anymore. But you know, I just thought I'll do this video like before I throw this one out. It's been over 12 months. You can only use this one for 12 months. So the only problem I have with this foundation is it's actually a lot better than other matte foundations, which I'm going to talk about like later. But if you have dry patches on your skin, so I'm a person who uses a spot treatment. I do breakout. So spot treatments usually make your skin peel in that particular area because they like kind of dry your acne out. So you kind of have dry patches, and if you have dry patches and you layer this like foundation on that, it kind of like doesn't sit so well. So your foundation also, that's dry skin, is seen a lot, versus when I use the Maybelline Fit Me one, that doesn't happen. It doesn't exaggerate the dry skin. It completely makes everything even. So other than that, if you have like, you don't have any dry patches but you're a really oily skin person, then you can definitely try this one. So yeah, I would suggest this for an oily skin person. So the finish of this foundation is matte, so it's a medium to full coverage foundation. That means if you layer it on, it like completely covers everything, but you can even go light-handed if that's what you want. And my shade is 310, and 310 matches me very perfectly. So this foundation is like both the things. I'm going to talk about the other Fenty foundation as well. Fenty foundations oxidize a lot. So initially when I apply on my face, you would be like, whoa, like that's too light. But give it 5 minutes and it blends beautifully, and it, you know, tone like comes down to my skin tone. So 310 is a perfect match for me. The next foundation we are going to talk about is the L'Oreal 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation. This has to be my new favorite foundation for the past 6 months. I've been obsessed with this foundation since the time I got it. I got this on recommendation of Tati. I miss her, dude. Anyway, I bought this on recommendation of her, and whenever it was available in India, and I really grabbed it as soon as it launched. So I would say all skin types can use this formula. It is a demi matte finish, so it means it's not too matte, it's not too dewy, so that means it can overall can cover all the skin spectrums. So it really looks good on anybody, and the coverage is sheer to medium. It's not a full coverage formula, that so it's really nice. It gives you that very natural finish. So if you apply one light layer, then you can kind of make it work as not exactly tinted moisturizer, but little more than that. And if you apply a second layer, then it'll act like a medium coverage foundation, but gives such a beautiful finish. I'm in the shade 260. It's a tad bit lighter to my skin. It matches my cheeks, but it doesn't match my jaw. So I kind of color correct around the jaw if I have to use this foundation, and then I layer it on so that it looks really perfect. So in the States, there are 40 shades of this foundation, but in India, there's sadly only 11. I know it sucks really bad, but if you can get your shade, then this is a really beautiful foundation. Then the next foundation we're going to talk about is the Smashbox Studio Skin. Now, the L'Oreal one and this have been my favorites. Not recently, but before that, when I had a lot better skin, because these give such a skin-like finish. But this one, I would say dry to combination skin can use. Oily skin people have to be a little careful to use this. So I would say it's a very light balance between dewy and demi matte. So I would say if you're an oily skin person, you'll be little at risk. So but this would be a winter foundation I would definitely use. Usually I just powder my face before the foundation. So I usually go in with any foundation because I don't tend to get oily if I use the powder. Dry skin to combination skin can definitely use this one. The finish is a little dewy. Then the coverage is sheer to medium. It's a very sheer to medium coverage foundation. You can build it up as much as you want, but if you won't get a full coverage, so it'll stop at a medium, sheer to medium. So if you want a skin-like finish, then this one, it did say Studio Skin does what it says. I'm in the shade 3.2. It says medium dark, so probably I'll go one shade lighter and one shade lighter, which is a little more yellowy in tone. So this one is a tad bit darker, but if I have to make it work, I can make it work with adding a more yellow concealer or something. Literally, it's really difficult to find a foundation which matches you, and all these foundations I have bought online, so it's really difficult to get. But I kind of at least try to get close to it, and I usually touch wood success, but sometimes I terribly fail, like you can see now. This foundation comes in 40 shades, so it covers a large spectrum of skin color. Then the next foundation we are going to talk about is the Maybelline Superstay Foundation. It's again one of my really favorite foundations. So skin type, I would say normal skin type to oily. Dry skin can, it might get a little drying for dry skin. The Fit Me one, all people can use, but this one, it's a Superstay matte foundation. So you have to be a little careful. It can get a little dry. So normal to oily, best foundation if you are somebody who gets really oily. Then the finish is matte. The coverage is medium to full. It can get full coverage, bro, full coverage. And I am in the shade 312 golden, and it kind of matches me really well. It's maybe a tad bit darker, but if I use a lighter concealer or something like that, then I can definitely work with this one. I'm in the shade golden. It has really beautiful yellow tones. So just so you have a reference, I actually don't know my MAC shade. I know my shade since years ago. I've tried it years ago, and I somehow remember it to be NC42. So I've always been telling NC42, but now I think I'm not NC42, because whenever I buy a foundation with the reference of NC42, it usually gets a little darker. I think I'm around NC40, maybe 41 or 41, maybe. Some people say I'm 35. I'm not sure. If you have one of the foundations here, then you'll understand what my skin tone is. So the next one is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. I have the sample size. Now this is again one more really beautiful foundation. If you have oily skin, you have got to get your hands on this. And if you're somebody like, you know, you have a function, you want your makeup to stay like morning to night without smudging, budge proof, high-end foundation, full coverage, matte, then you know this one would be like the foundation to go. So I would say normal to oily skin people can use it, and it is a very proper matte foundation. I mean, baby, if it dries down, it's not moving, so you need to work a little fast with this as well. And for coverage, it's a very full coverage formula, and I'm in the shade cashew. So yeah, then next foundation is the Sugar Cosmetics Ace of Face Foundation Stick. Now this one, I made a review of Sugar Cosmetics on YouTube and everybody came for me for not liking this one. So I mentioned that, you know, I'm getting dry patches over, like if I'm wearing this foundation. The same issue which I had with my Fenty foundation fell down. So the same problem which I had with this. So my skin was like kind of flaking off, the foundation was flaking off. And I prep my skin like I prep for all foundations. I added a lot of moisturizer, I added lots of primer, serum, everything. And then only, of course, I went in with this foundation. But people were like, oh, maybe you could just use a moisturizer, it would have been fine. I'm like, really now? So yeah, if you have like really beautiful skin which doesn't flake, doesn't dehydrate, doesn't do anything, then this would be a good foundation. I mean, I like the finish of the foundation, it looks really nice. But my only problem is that if I have dry patches on my face, I cannot use this. So I can only use this on the days when my skin is like doing really well, has like fully nourished everywhere, etc. type of thing. So I would say normal to oily skin people can use this foundation. It's a matte finish formula. It is medium to full coverage. It does give a lot of coverage. If you apply two layers, it'll give you like full coverage. And I'm the shade 40 Brie. Don't hate me. I know a lot of people like this foundation. It's a good formula. Like I've used this foundation more than like 10 times till now. On the days my skin is really good, it looks bomb on my skin. I'm not lying. But if I have to, you know, use a spot treatment and next day I have to use, if the dry skin is there, it doesn't work really well. So it depends. And you know, one of my friend, I've used this foundation of one of my friend. I had a darker shade, I gave it to her. It looks really beautiful on her because she doesn't have any acne issues or anything like that. So you know, it really depends on the skin type. This one not so good for me. Maybe one day when I have really good skin, this will start looking good on me. Then next foundation, again we have one more foundation from Fenty. This is the hydrating foundation. Now this foundation, really beautiful. So any skin type can use this foundation. If you have oily skin, of course you have to powder your skin a lot more, but really beautiful. I like this one more than the pro matte one. This is like a demi matte finish. It's not so dewy like they say, like though they say hydrating, it's not dewy. It's a very nice demi matte finish, so anybody can use it. If you have dry skin, then you can go in with the lighter powder. If you have oily skin, then you can of course go in with the powder which is more mattifying. The coverage is medium to full, and I'm in the shade 300. They have 40 shades available of this foundation. I think even more, maybe 44, I think. And I'm in the shade 300 for this one. So 300 is a very close match. This also oxidizes a lot, and it kind of matches my skin tone in the end, but it's a little tad bit darker. So I would say if you're my skin tone, if you want to buy a foundation, then go for 310 from Fenty. So one disclaimer again, that I do appear three shades darker on camera for some reason. I don't know, maybe 2-3 shades darker. I don't know if it's lighting, I don't know if it's my lens, what is the big scene, but I do appear a tad bit darker on the screen. So that's that. So like, you know, judge my skin according to the foundation shades and not according to what you see. The next foundation is this L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte. This foundation is by far, like if I compare Sugar to this, then Sugar is a far better foundation in terms of matte formulas. I've tried this foundation, bro, because of the hype. So many people have been talking about it. It's a constantly marketed. I've given this one try more than like 5-6 times when I have like good skin, bad skin. So this is a very good full coverage matte formula, okay? But the only problem is like whenever I apply this, my dry patches are exactly exaggerated. I don't know why. I've tried so many different primers, primer water, etc. But always I end up, if I have a dry patch, then this always exaggerates it a lot more. Doesn't happen with other of my favorite, foundations. So we're thinking, she always has dry patches, that's the reason no foundation works for her. But you know, there are people like me who would like have to use a spot treatment. So yeah, this does exaggerate your like dry spots a lot worse than any of the foundations I've mentioned. So this is a big 5 out of 10 for me. So if you want to try this, then I would say oily skin people can try it. Finish is a matte finish. It's a medium to full coverage, more like full coverage formula. I'm in the shade 108, and I think there are only 8 shades available in India, which is very sad. And this is the darkest shade, and this is a lot lighter for me on my skin. Next foundation is the Milani Conceal and Perfect foundation. This is in the shade Warm Sand. I bought this foundation from Beauty Bay back when Beauty Bay was shipping to India. Free shipping after 3000 rupees. I miss those days. Now it is so expensive. Anyways, so I got this, like I got this foundation from that website because India had I think 7 shades maybe, which was very bad, and I thought the darkest shade also might be lighter on me. So I was ordering a couple of things from their website, then I popped off, like, you know, added this foundation also in that. So I'm in the shade Warm Sand, but you know, you won't get it in India. So I would say any skin type can use this. A really nice formula. It's a demi matte finish, the most beautiful finish. I really like demi matte foundations. Then it's a full coverage formula. You can make it like, you know, kind of make it medium if you add like a tiny bit of product, but it's like a proper full coverage, but it doesn't look cakey or heavy. It looks really nice on the skin. And I'm in the shade Warm Sand, and this shade is a tad bit darker to my skin and it's too neutral. So maybe I will try like a shade which is more lighter. I think that will suit me a lot better than this one. But it's a beautiful formula, one of my very favorite foundations. So yeah guys, those are the 10 foundations I wanted to talk to you guys about in this video. Let me know if you guys want to see more such videos with other foundations I have. I would absolutely love to do it. I just want this to be like a proper guide for you for a foundation, if in case you want to use me as a reference or you want to know what I think about a certain foundation, then this is it. 10 foundations under, I hope, 20 minutes. So yeah, that's it for the review or guide, whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.